Another week begins, and you know what that means. It's time for Multimedia Monday.
Yay!
Hey, Alex.
Hi, Danny. It's Multimedia time.
It's time for Multimedia. We're ready to get educated. I was seeing the overall education among Twitch chatters starting to dip, so I figured we'd do our part and try to educate the general public.
Are we, like, educating them to a test? Is there, like, a CD-i test standard that all, like, standardized people have to go through?
Yeah, we're preparing you for the Twitch SATs.
Okay.
If you want to get a perfect 1600 on your gamer SATs, you better watch every single second of the stream and commit it to memory. This is a thing we do every so often where we play Philip CD-i games. We're going through A to Z, and, I have some idea of what we're in for, and also not much of an idea of what we're in for, if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
Alex, why don't you thank some folks?
I want to thank Sepasai for the 100 bits before the show. Do appreciate that. Welcome.
Welcome.
And thank you, Inari Fox, 46-month resub, the big fat 46. Thank you so very much.
Big fat 46. Thank you.
Thank you all.
Ready to get this started?
Yes. The wacky world of SATs, yes, exactly.
So I mention this every time we do our Philip CD-i thing, but I got a whole bunch of games here in MAME that are newly emulated for the Philip CD-i. Newly emulated, I mean, within the last year or so. But there's a few dozen games here, and non-games, that I'm pretty sure no one has ever seen or played, and definitely not streamed.
Mm-mm.
So we'll be going through the whole list, A to Z. We made it halfway through A last time, and we're going to be picking things up with Alle over CD-i. April through May, 1995, from the Netherlands.
Cool.
This is going to prepare us for the Philip CD-i before we start storybook time.
Okay. Games.
Where's the game? Show me the game. Ma'am, you were working right before the stream.
Yeah, sometimes you have to finagle with the whatchamacallit.
Oh my god, you put in one Multimedia Monday intro and the whole thing shits the bed. Well, let's start Ma'am over. Jeez. How about...
Allez over CD-i.
What do you think that means? There we go.
CD-i, the CD-i years.
I think it means like all over CD-i or something.
Mm-hmm. Rubbing your face all over the CD-i.
Mm-hmm. Just to make sure you're not allergic.
What if you are allergic? And then you do that and then you've got like CD-i hives.
Well, at least now you know. You can That's go to true. the fine socialized doctors of the Netherlands in order to treat it. Here in America, you have to be a little bit more careful.
Mm-mm.
Now, Alex, what does that say?
Diegt over Siegt is the Philips consumen. The Philips consumen, I know.
De interactieve compact disc, ofwel CD-i, is de meest verbazende uitvinding sinds de televisie.
Thank you.
Met de CD-speler.
So it's the greatest invention since the television, I think, is what I heard them say.
Deze CD-speler is nog niet voorzien van een zogenaamde digital video cartridge. Dit betekent
de digital video cartridge.
Voorbeelden in dit programma in digital video.
Unfortunately, not emulated here in MAME. We'll just have to use our imagination.
When is that going to be? Oh, look at the Berenstain Bears!
They translated the Berenstain Bears to all the languages.
Kinderprogramma's. En natuurlijk uw eigen foto-cd's.
En foto-cd's.
Mmm. Caesar's World of Boxing. Beeld, geluid en voyeur.
So we need to... So who can we contact in MAME to get this working? Mr. MAME? Mrs.
Who do we have
MAME?
To bribe? Is that how it works?
Mix MAME? Who do we need to give money to? Ms. MAME?
Ah, here's the standard CD-i controller that looks like a spoon. Oh, I wish I had four of those.
We had one of those once, that model, I think.
Dude, if you dropped one of those from a tall building, you would kill someone. No doubt. They would be dead instantly.
I would like to not kill people.
Those things are at least like 30 or 40 pounds each. Let's go to CD-i Bedienen.
Bedienen. Ah! It's coming right for me.
Oh, no!
What do you think of CD-i? Oh, I see. It's Bon Jovi, Brian Adams. Oh, man.
There's a Pavarotti disc.
Star Trek 6. Star Trek 6, everybody.
The best one.
You've never seen Star Trek 6. Don't lie.
Nah, I haven't.
about Star Trek 6? I know it's not the one with the whales or San Francisco. Star Trek 2.
Now, there's a whole lot of these discs here in MAME, and I intend to try out every single one of them. Turns out every single year, Philips sent out a whole bunch of discs intending to acquaint people with the Philips CD-i in multiple regions. What can the CD-i do for me?
Een Philips CD-i-speler kan veel meer dan u denkt. Het is in feite een combinatie van...
It looks like, you know that controller? Uh-huh. It looks like you could smack someone with that.
Network music?
Photo CDs!
You can play photo CDs!
Foto CD heeft laten zetten, kleurrijk op uw televisie laat zien.
Photographic quality. Face kitchen!
Face kitchen, folks! We got the face kitchen!
You can't just put that in there, act like it's a normal game.
It is a normal game.
Maybe in the Netherlands. See, we didn't make up face kitchen.
What if we had that? I want that hi-fi system.
Oh, me too.
I wanna get CD shoe.
The crying game.
It's a crying game video CD.
Wow, this is like a Psycho's Night Out.
Thank you, exclamation. Let's play for the 5 months, five slutty months. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, we're gonna play some CD shoot and then watch the crying game.
Is it a game? No, I need to look this up. Hold on, CD-i.
What crying. If the crying game was an actual game on the CD-i?
Okay, here we see some. It's a movie.
We see some European region discs here. You can tell because they're vertical format. They actually open from the side. It's very strange. It'll confuse you the first time you see one. Maybe we'll see some of those games today.
Unfortunately, the crying game video CD is just the movie.
Dang. Well, I'm counting that as representation regardless. Maple, thank you for the 100 bits.
Thank you.
I take my crying very seriously. Look, some people, they just try to hone their craft. We have the World Championships of Crying coming up.
Oh, yeah. Kinden?
Hey, there they are.
Where is their man?
Yeah, you can use the Rolo controller. Yeah, I got one of those. It's new in box. I keep meaning to take it out, but also it's new in box, so.
Hey, there's Sandy Circus Adventure.
Hey. There was something called Tom back there. What the hell was that?
It's Tom.
Now, there's the LGBT rep. What can you tell me about the old cartoon jukebox? $59.99 foofs!
Would you pay $59.99 foofs for this? Yeah, the T in LGBT is for Tom. Yeah.
Wow, there's a whole product catalog here. Fucking Face Kitchen. You really gonna act like this is a real thing people should play? It's $69.95 foofs!
It costs more than the other one!
In the gezicht and keuken van Oepie. Ben je klaar? Dan kan jouw figuur echt praten of een liedje zingen.
Hey, Ridge, glad you got to enjoy lovely cards.
Oh god, lovely cards.
That's a bad face. That's a really bad face. RS's Allerdusk's birth disc.
Yeah, what's that? Oh! I know that.
Look at those bunnies. They're making pants at the Pants Factory.
Where is the streamer? Where is the busy town person who's a streamer as her job? Tim and Bear. Oh, that's probably Tim and Bear.
Yeah.
We love Tim and Bear.
Our buddies. Oh, no, they're in the hospital.
Are they okay?
Tim, what'd you do?
This looks worse than the other one.
It does. Tim, are you licensed to practice doctor? Licensed to practice doctor. This is already making me less educated. Tom's Magic Picture Show.
Okay, what's this? Hey, it's cheaper than the other ones. Wow. I like that pride flag.
Your hook can be any color you want.
Mm-hmm. Are you educated?
I'm feeling a little more educated. Oh my god!
Put it on, baby! This was at MAGFest, did you know?
Yeah, some people got to play this for the first time at MAGFest. Oh god, what a freeze frame.
There he is. I wonder if there is a Dutch dub. I don't know if this is in English or not.
You know, I'm willing to bet that there is. They probably went above and beyond for the Netherlands.
Which one do you want?
I'll take all of them, thank you. I'm building a museum.
No, you're building a Stonehenge.
Oh, yeah. That'd be really sturdy.
Mm-hmm.
If you had a bunch of stacked up CDIs, not even a hurricane could knock that down.
I was going to say, I want to tell the seasons and the equinoxes with the CDI.
Lovely system. Truly exquisite. Oh, it's got matchline technology. You can pause and stop.
Beautiful.
Give you the Bryan Adams CD for free to take to bonfire night.
The CD-i 210 is wat minder luxe uitgevoerd dan de CD-i 220.
I love these glamour shots. It's like their school photo. It's their yearbook photo.
I also want the portable CDI. Mm-hmm. That's more like a status symbol nowadays. I'd have to, like, wear it around town.
Would you? Where would you wear it?
To the domain.
Okay, that's pretty cool.
You gotta go where people would appreciate it.
Yeah, and no one appreciates,
Gold Club!
Okay, hold on.
Iedere koper van een Philips CD-i kan lid worden van de CD-i Gold Club.
What is it?
Kring van CD-i-bezitters met bijzondere voorrechten.
It's like a subscription service, like PlayStation Plus?
What is this? The Philips Trend Card?
They just give you discs in the mail? Compton's Interactive
Encyclopedia. And Compton's.
Yeah, this is an ad for the CD-i playable on the CD-i. A whole lot of discs.
Seventh Guest.
Designed for demonstration units.
Space Ace. And the CD-i catalog. I think that's a magazine.
Yeah, you get a magazine, you get photo CDs. This is a good deal. Can we sign up?
Mm-hmm. Let's join the CD-i Gold Club.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's make up a fake Netherlands address.
Okay.
All right, I'm sold.
All right.
I'm sold on the CD-i. Stop. Thank you, Case Interactive DeBilt. Okay, now that we all know what the Philips CD-i is, let's see all the possibilities afforded by the future. We're going to get an advanced reading of the classic story Beauty and the Beast. Grab your popcorn.
I got it.
Have a sit down.
I'm sitting down.
Rolling in the cart.
All right, we're all watching.
Teacher doesn't feel like teaching today.
These are my favorite Mondays.
Teacher's going through a divorce, so nothing but wheeling in the TV this week. Teacher starts weeping at the sight of the beast, being like, why can't I find a man like that?
Danny. And yeah, this is in Dutch.
No, this is not in Dutch.
Oh, this is
in English.
Dutch. Never mind, I take it back. This is in England. Oh, it's one of these with the wizard, isn't it? Oh,
yep.
Get that.
We're going back to story time. The wizard.
Hello, and welcome to the Enchanted Forest. Are you ready to go on a storybook adventure with me?
Uh-huh.
Listen closely and follow the star from my magic robe.
Ooh.
When the star is over the book and you press a button, you can see the story.
Ragnar, I'm glad you also got to play Wacky World of Miniature Golf at MAGFest. I'm so glad they set that up. Like hundreds of new people were exposed to Wacky World of Miniature Golf.
And you press a button, you will leave the disc.
You
can move the star anywhere you like. And remember, if you see the story first, it will help you play the games. Have fun!
That's the most important part, having fun.
Yeah, beautiful lifelike animation.
Hey, Rad Raccoon, welcome. So, this thing, it was released in multiple languages. Weirdly enough, I couldn't find a good scan of the English cover, which is why I posted the Italian cover when I promoted this on Twitter. The only site you can find these scans on is called World of CDI, and it has a slideshow. And each image it describes as big image. So for the for Beauty and the Beast, it described it as Beauty and the Beast, big Italian version.
Big Italian.
To stop the story, it's time to go big Italian with Beauty and the Beast. It's a story you may know, but maybe you don't know this version of it.
I like that background. This looks like our old background.
Yeah. I want to say this is a contemporary with the Disney adaptation, since that was like, what, 91?
Yeah. Actually, let me see when Beauty and the Beast came out. Yeah, 91.
Oh, I hope you're ready to be edutained.
Mia Farrow's here.
I got some stealth education in this stream.
Mordecai Gerstein.
Good job, Mordecai. They didn't get Bobby McFerrin for this one.
Morning, long, long ago, in a land that's now forgotten, a merchant whistled happily as he saddled his horse. He was off to meet a ship, bringing him crates of precious ivory and Chinese silk.
Let me know if the audio is good on this.
"We shall be rich," he told his daughters. "And I'll bring back gifts for each of you."
Wow, this art.
"A new gown,
I love
father,"
the art.
"Cried Edwina, his oldest. "She has gowns," whined Sybil, his middle daughter. "Bring me a gown, and a cape of green silk, and a hat covered with parrot feathers." "Enough."
A little low, I can boost it some more.
"You'll both have gowns and more." Then turning to his youngest, he said, "But you, Beauty, always so
Yeah,
shy.
France just no
what
longer
shall I bring
exists.
For you?"
Mm-hmm.
Beauty blushed and handed him his cloak. "There's nothing I really need, Father. Just come home quickly and safely." "There must be something," insisted her father.
I want to see this animated, well, like, said, Link, the Faces of
Rose,
Evil.
Father.
Yes.
"It's not too much trouble." "What a ninny," jeered her sisters. "She wants a rose." "A rose it will be," said the merchant. He waved goodbye and galloped off.
"Well, I leave in the morning. If you don't hear from me, send Link."
But when he got to the port, he learned that the ship had been wrecked in a storm.
Oh.
While his ivory and silk lay at the bottom of the sea.
This beast is what all true warriors strive for.
He said to himself, "I invested everything. Now I'm penniless.
I harvested so many elephants for their ivory, and now look."
He started for home.
20,000 dead elephants for nothing, huh?
The evening, snow became sleet, and deep in the woods, he realized he'd lost his way.
Well, that sucks.
Then, ow! Through the storm, he glimpsed a faint light. He spurred his horse toward it.
Can you see this?
Yeah, I can see him.
Okay. Just want to make sure we're all comfortable.
No, we're all thank you. I love that face.
He looked around and found himself in the peaceful warmth of a moonlit garden.
Yeah, where's Gaston?
A glowing palace. Amazed.
Where is the horny candle?
And climbed slowly up the
Where's his boyfriend,
stairs.
The clock?
At the top, massive doors of bronze swung silently open, and he stared into a dazzling hall.
Ooh.
Hello? Oh. Hello? Hello?
Welcome, Daddy Mulk.
Answered the echo. And then, except for the distant song of a nightingale, silence.
I like how pink the house is.
Yeah. Interesting use of color in this.
I was gonna say, I really like the art in this compared to the other ones.
That was a legged whale. This beast.
That's normal. That's normal.
In a great dining hall, he found silver platters of steaming roasts. Wine in crystal carafes.
Yeah, soon you'll be able to buy all these images as NFTs. The market's blowing up, you'll see.
Yeah, now is the right time for us to enter the NFT market.
Let's talk to Square Enix.
Hungry as he was, the poor man waited for someone to come and invite him to dine. But finally, the palace struck midnight.
There's so many cool clocks in this place.
He sat and was about to help himself when he saw his glass slowly fill with wine. "The place is bewitched," he muttered as food floated onto his plate.
It's spelling out a word. S. Oh.
I feel bad. If I wasn't an enchanted thing and food started flying towards me, I'd be like, I'll give it a chance.
Yeah.
I try it.
Huge feather bed with silken sheets. He lay across it, intending to rest for just a moment, but fell into a deep sleep. Sunlight woke him, and he found himself wearing a fine linen nightshirt.
It's pretty rude of him. I'd sleep on the couch.
He dressed. You wouldn't trust flying food? Well, that's your problem. I'll trust it.
Who is master here? In the middle of a great empty ballroom, he stopped. Thank you, dear host. Thank you for saving my life.
I like that the story's about Belle's father.
He's kind of a dipshit. I like that.
Like, Belle, who cares?
When he caught the scent of roses, he thought of his daughter, Beauty.
Cartman, yeah. Thank you for the 100 bits. Yeah, for some reason they didn't adapt this part.
It's funny, there is actually a version of Beauty and the Beast by Disney that the early version did adapt this part. They did have the sisters, and Gaston wasn't even in it.
Wow.
Yeah.
He searched the garden.
They had to add in a marketable sex pest.
They did!
Then he reached out and picked it. At that moment...
Hey, Sass, welcome to Edutainment. God, so many good faces!
He fell to the ground, and when he dared to look up... A huge, ugly beast glared down at him with blazing eyes.
So, oh, he's like a mastodon or something.
He's like a hog guy.
It's Ganon.
I have fed you and sheltered you, and you repay me by stealing what I love most in the world. My roses. You must die.
Guess who, Billy Bones?
Please,
I want to see Bulgarian Treasure Planet, the CD-i adaptation.
Sir, and don't argue. You must
I still need to see that.
It's so good, dude.
No harm. The rose was for my daughter, Beauty.
You have a daughter?
I have three lovely daughters who depend on me, my lord.
Call me Beast. You have one chance to live. If one of your daughters willingly comes here to take your place, I will spare you.
I would never sacrifice my daughters.
Silence! You may go home, but at the end of 1 week, either you or one of your daughters must come to me. Now go.
At this, the merchant felt the garden spin around him, and he fainted dead away. When he opened his eyes, he was in his own bed. Oh, father,
he teleported.
He's magic.
We're so glad you're alive. Your horse galloped into the yard last night.
Yeah, I also think he should send one of the shitty daughters.
This was in your hand.
And send one of your good daughters, not the shitty ones.
Began to weep. And he told
I just think it would be funnier if he sent one of the high strong ones.
And so, in 1 week, he concluded, I shall kiss you all goodbye for the last time. Beauty burst into tears.
But father, wailed Sybil, without you we'll starve.
It's all her fault, snapped Edwina. She had to.
That'd be cool if
rose.
There was like a Columbia house, yes, for Philip
Sybil.
CD-i discs.
She should
get 10 for a
beast
penny.
In your place, father. He'd give her roses.
That's enough, cried the merchant. Beauty wept unconsolably.
Yeah, why would you name one of your daughters her Beauty? Right, it just seems like...
Please forgive me.
Kind of a dick move to your other kids.
The week passed slowly.
Beautiful child, and the ugly
ones. Awakened at dawn by the clatter.
My lesser children.
She ran out to the yard, and there stood a magnificent white stallion with a golden saddle.
Cool horse.
Horse got a butt that won't quit.
Beauty,
Danny.
No. I forbid it.
I'm just saying what we're all thinking.
I guess some of us are thinking that.
Drowned out by the thudding hooves. Beauty laid her cheek against the horse's neck. It was like riding the wind.
She seems pretty nonchalant about this.
She's been waiting for this.
Maybe she just wants to get out of the household because she can't stand her other sisters.
The mist cleared, and there was the palace, gleaming in the dewy sunlight.
Dewy?
It's dewy.
When the great bronze doors opened without a sound, she cried out, but she saw no beast. She saw no one.
pluck every rose. I just think it'd be funny if he just fucked up his rose garden. Just like, I don't know, this is what I'm doing now.
I like flowers. Beauty's room. Boys, stay out.
She entered a room full of sunlight, roses, and shelves of books.
Fuck up the roses.
A book lying on the table slowly opened. And Beauty read, "Dearest Beauty, have no fear. You alone are mistress here.
You're kind of wasting pages by putting one word per page.
My roses so sweet, all that I have is laid at your feet." "What does this mean?" cried Beauty. "What do you want of me?"
Cool pose.
But there was no answer.
I really do like the octopus lantern there.
I've been noticing that, yeah.
I want one of those. Can we get one of those?
Set with roses and silver.
Sure.
And all her most favorite foods and cakes, but she touched nothing.
There's a cornucopia there.
Hours passed in eerie stillness.
Is a cornucopia just ornamental, or do people actually stuff food in it?
I don't know. And she heard the sound. Do people put food in a cornucopia?
Good evening.
Maybe back then.
Maybe.
Growled a rasping voice. When Beauty saw the beast, the earth seemed to drop from under her. She could never have imagined anything so monstrous. Good evening, sir.
Call me Beast.
Okay.
Did you come of your own choice, Beauty?
What's this voice that she's giving?
I know! No offense to Mia Farrow, but you're doing a weird voice for the Beast.
I'm the Beast!
Oh, it's lovely, Beast. Thank you.
And Beauty, do you find me very ugly?
Beauty faltered and looked down. Her heart pounded. I cannot lie, Beast. I find you ugly.
He is a little bit elfin.
Oh, he does look like Al.
I am ugly.
He's got that ridged nose.
Mm-hmm.
I am ugly, he roared.
Willie!
And I am the Beast. He glared at her.
Then he covered his eyes and after a moment said softly,
Beauty, may I sit with you each evening while you dine?
If you wish, said Beauty.
And Beauty, will you be my wife?
She closed her eyes. I cannot, Beast.
No.
I do not love you.
It is like a Shin Chan voice.
And turned away.
Good night.
Thank you, Cartman, for the 100 bits.
Thank you.
That's what you call strategy. That's what he should have done. Okay, I love my wife. I was also thinking Borat voice. When he said, my wife!
My wife.
Beauty dreamt that night of a nightingale that flew in her window and perched on her bed. The bird sang a sweet, haunting song.
Dearest Beauty, have no fear. You alone are mistress here.
That looks sick, this art.
This looks really good.
Not your eyes.
This is one of the best looking CD-i games we've played.
It's got a good style to it.
Mm-hmm.
Sunlight woke her. She dressed and wandered out among roses of every color and fragrance. She came upon a huge cage full of strange and wondrous birds. They looked at her and fluttered helplessly against the bars. I wish I could free you, she said. Then she thought of the Beast and shuddered. Each evening he sat opposite her and asked about her day and watched her every move.
Yeah, great way to win someone over, dude.
Do you love me yet?
So you like me?
Full of mysteries. One night, feeling bold, she asked him, Beast, when will you kill me? He flinched and his eyes filled with horror.
Don't you know, Beauty? I would never harm you in any way. please forgive me.
The next evening, as she waited for the beast to appear...
Yeah, just kill me already, please.
...there was a sudden fluttering wings, and a bird flew around and around the room. Then she saw the beast in the doorway, and quick as any cat, his arm shot out, and the bird was in his fist. Beauty could see it. It was a nightingale. Oh, please, she said, let it go.
Whew.
Beast.
Thanks for not killing that fucking bird, asshole. Free,
she looked again into his eyes, and it was like looking into a forest. Behind a tree, she saw a fox. Here, the flash of some bird. There, a young fawn.
Beauty.
Well, Sifakrat, thank you for the sub.
Well, thank you.
I'm getting lots of hee-hoos from this.
Oh, yeah, a lot of guffaws.
Dear beast.
And yeah, I wish this was narrated by Jack Nicholson like the other one.
She dreamed that night that she rode on the back of a wolf.
And then the beast released the bird.
Through a fantastic
she rode a wolf. I was in a movie, Wolf. You remember that?
Through the nightingale. Then she heard her father calling her. Beauty! Beauty! With his voice growing fainter and fainter. She woke and realized that it had been weeks since she'd thought of him. Oh, father, she said aloud, if only I could see you. She glanced into the mirror by her bed, and there she saw her father. He looked old and sick. His lips moved, speaking her name. She burst into tears, and that evening when the beast appeared, she fell to her knees and said, please, beast, let me go to my father. I'm afraid he is dying.
I really like the beast legs in this.
Just for 1 week, said Beauty.
Yeah, they're all like, oh my god, look at them. So.
It's like a deer or something.
Mm-hmm.
I am only a beast. But I would die if you left me, Beauty.
I am just a little creature.
Awakened that night by
I am a little guy. It is my birthday.
And the sound of something crashing through the woods. She left her bed and hurried through the moonlit maze until she stood in the rose garden. The beast stepped out of the black shadows.
Beauty, he said. You may go to your father for 1 week. But if you stay away longer, I will surely die. Take this ring, leave it on your table, and you will wake in your father's house.
Oh, thank you, dear beast. Thank you. She took the beast's hand and kissed it and smelled the forest. She felt the coarse fur. And the sharp claws.
Do we gotta roll all this?
I was gonna say, she getting horny.
I am a beast and a fool. But Beauty, my heart is good.
She looked into his eyes.
Yeah, she should just leave. Wept.
She saw such pain.
Beauty, will you be my wife?
Dearest beast, she answered, but looked away and shook her head. Returning to her room, she put the ring on her table, and when she awoke, she was indeed at her father's house. Beauty, cried her
father.
Yeah,
don't go back, girl. Just let him die.
Yeah, he's just a beast.
Yeah, what's he gonna do?
You will make me well again. When she looked around,
then she starts thinking, well, he is a beast.
I do like the fur.
And the claws.
Mm-hmm. And the smell of it. I like that she's like, wow, I love the way this guy smells. Like, yeah, okay, that's normal.
No matter how much I spend, it's never empty.
Wow.
And my sisters, asked Beauty, how are they?
Dead.
Thanks to the gold, they're both married now. I'll send for them.
Yeah, even better.
Edwina had
they're out of our lives forever. Never have to worry about those assholes ever again.
Sybil had married a sly man who was mean and petty. The sisters were both miserable. They secretly hoped that Beauty had been torn to shreds by the beast.
Whoa!
When they saw her, radiant and looking like a princess, It was all they could do to hide their jealousy and rage. Oh, we've missed
Real
you so, they said.
Fucking happy for you.
And I've missed you. But I can only stay 1 week.
Yeah, I also heard a slime man.
He'd die if I didn't return. The evil thing, said Edwina. Let him die. Yes, cried Sybil. Then his palace would be ours. And of course,
I mean, they make a good point.
You would be free. No, said Beauty. He's been kind to me, and I promised. Her sisters stared at her. You must be mad, they said.
Oh my god, they're so
Later,
high.
Edwina drew Sybil aside. She wants all the wealth for herself, the greedy pig. Yes, said Sybil. Let's keep her here beyond the week. Either the beast will die, or he'll tear her limb from limb for being late. Perfect, said Edwina. So when the time came for Beauty to leave, her sisters rubbed their eyes with onion, and tears flowed. Oh, please stay, blubbered Edwina. Please, sobbed Sybil. For father's sake. Beauty smelled the onion and doubted her sister's tears. Her father wept too.
Ah, the onion trick.
She found
she's like, they're always rubbing their eyes with onions. You know my sisters.
Until the beast and his palace began to seem unreal, like some children's fairy tale. After 10 days, she had a dream. She was alone at the beast's table, but it was dark and cold. From far off, she heard a pitiful groaning. Beast? Is that you? She asked. Beast? Answer me. Forgive me for staying away so long. But she heard the groans growing weaker and weaker. Don't die, Beast! Don't die! Cried Beauty, running frantically through the moonlit maze. Then she heard the nightingale singing. Dearest Beauty, the hour is late. Happiness won't always wait. Run to the center of your own heart's maze. There, find love for all your days.
Why is this so psychological?
It is. It's turning into a mansion of hidden souls.
Yeah, what the hell?
Table and fell back asleep. When she woke again, she was in the beast's
And there hasn't been a horny candlestick in his gay clock. It's pissing me off.
The beast lay sprawled in the moonlight.
What about the caked up tea kettle?
Yeah, I wasn't going to mention how caked up she was, because I feel that's like fan fiction, but...
No, that's official.
That's official? Okay.
Please live and marry me, and I'll never leave you again. At these words, the sun rose, and the great birdcage in the garden burst open, but Beauty barely noticed.
Yeah, that would be inconsiderate to ask Jack Nicholson to narrate a part about a hedge maze.
Yeah.
Bad memories.
Face, he was transformed into a young and handsome prince.
He's handsome!
Dear Beauty, he said in a sweet voice, your love has
saved
my
life. He's not that handsome.
And
Sorry.
Changed me from a beast to a man who can love you in return.
Chat just instantly explodes with being like, no, turn him back.
Boo, go back. I'm with you. He looks like shit, much like in the Disney film.
Your heart was always kind. My heart was always yours, said the beast prince, as he took her hand and led her up the stairs of the palace. The doors swung open, and there stood Beauty's father and family. Over them hovered the nightingale who had brought them there. Dearest Beauty, full of grace, your heart's as lovely as your face. You freed
Yay.
The prince, transformed
well,
the beast.
She did it.
Now all
beast is now a generic-looking white guy.
Kind of looks like a jester.
He does, but I won't go. I don't feel the need to justify with his looks.
Thank you.
Look how unhappy the sisters look.
They were married
like,
that very day. Everyone
Beast does look like Quaker Oats.
Everyone, that is, except the sisters, who were rigid with jealousy and rage. Dear sisters, said Beauty, give up your jealousy and hate. Open your hearts, and my
go fucketh thine
can
selves.
Be your own. But the sisters refused. And in moments, beginning with their hearts, they turned to stone.
Two statues at the doors of the
palace. There they stood through the years and watched as Beauty and the Prince filled the palace with laughter, children, and roses.
Hey, Pikachu, welcome to the good ending.
Long and happily, and their story lives after them, and it always will, as long as there is someone to tell it.
Thank you, Punch, for the 100 bits. Yeah, Beauty's gonna take a sledgehammer to her sisters.
Wow, man.
That's it!
Her sisters got owned big time. And that's the story of Beauty and the Beast, as told by Mia Farrow on the Philips CD-i.
I feel educated.
I do too. Now you get to see an alternate version of the story as made popular by Disney.
I don't know how I feel about it, but I like how bizarre and psychological it was. Thank you, Cartman, for the bits.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. We've all learned a lot today. So what was, 1988. Yeah, originally these were on VHS tapes, and then they were adapted to the Philips CD-i. Yeah, you just watched something.
Yeah, you learned. Do you feel educated now? We educated you.
So what were the elements that weren't in the Disney movie? The hedge maze.
The sisters.
The sisters, of course, is the big one.
The dad being a rich guy.
Yeah.
A crazy inventor.
Meanwhile, Disney added a whole bunch of mansion residents.
Mm-hmm.
It added Gaston and his, the little guy who loves Gaston. What's that guy's name?
Lefou,
of course.
Lefou.
Story. Game. Each one of these pictures will let you play a different game.
Let's play the Beast game.
Beauty's sisters ask their father to bring them expensive gifts. What gift does Beauty want?
She wanted a rose.
Yes, the only gift Beauty wants is a single rose.
Cool.
Now it's your turn to have a party in the castle.
Oh.
Who will you choose to be your guest of honor?
Who will be our guest of honor?
The prince, the belle, the sister, or Quaker Oats' dad? I think Quaker Oats' dad.
All right, he's had it tough.
He's had a lot of bad life.
Choice. Your party will be fit for a king.
You've earned this one, Dad.
Good job.
In one picture, the palace doors are open. Which one?
Well, you think I'm stupid?
Danny, it's for babies.
Is not like the others.
Out of here. It's lacks the sophistication I demand from my Philips CD-i games.
Bye-bye.
You enjoyed the disc. Here are the names of some other titles.
Maybe
I
Pegasus.
I think we actually watched the Br'er Rabbit disc.
I think we did too. Postmodern media? This is absolutely not postmodern, thank you.
Seems pretty modern.
Yeah.
We're stuck directly in modern. Well, I don't know how many of these there are, but we've played at least 5 of them, and there's no doubt more, so look forward to those. I want to see the dark stories of Aesop's fables. That's one of them.
How dark do you think they're going to make it?
Pretty dark, probably, because it's specifically called Dark Tales or something.
Ooh.
It is illegal to make unauthorized copies of this software.
Okay, we won't.
It's protected under the federal copyright law. Include fines as much as $50,000 and jail terms in the Beast's mansion.
Eh, worth it.
Everybody out there rushing to pirate CD-i games now. That was good.
Yeah, all right. That was fun.
Another good Philips CD-i storybook disc. All right, we return to our A to Z of Philips CD-i. We've done Olles over CD-i. During the pre-show, we showed a little bit of Anne Willen Presents the Food of France, which we showcased previously. And why don't we pick up with Arcade Classics, released only in Europe.
So are these going to be real arcade games or bootleg knockoffs of arcade games? What do you think? Chat, what do you think?
Place your bets.
I think knockoffs.
Yeah, what is classic arcade to the Philips CD-i circa 1992? Let's play that CD-i. Oh, it's second generation CD-i. There are going to be games like retro PS2. Yeah, maybe.
I was assuming it's going to be like retro on PS2.
Nope, this is a real Namco production.
What?
They got Namco.
What?
They got Namco in on this one.
What? I'm genuinely surprised.
I screwed it up again. Let's do that again.
Okay,
we're starting this over. And hey, check it out. It's the Philips CD-i logo. This must be a second generation disc.
It must be. I like the way the water turns into the red light.
Me too.
What does that symbolize?
I wonder if this is unofficial or official.
It's gotta be totally unofficial. Totally unofficial. Whoa!
Oh, they got Namco in on this. All right, there we go.
Okay.
Arcade classics.
This looks bootleg.
Well, we have Galaxian, Miss Pac-Man, Galaga, and Quit.
Let's actually play the game.
All right.
Welcome, Crimson. We are playing actual Namco licensed games on the CD-i. This looks.
Hey, there she is. That's why we haven't seen her lately. She's on the moon.
Oh, okay. That's what happens when you're in wife exile.
That's what happens when you get divorced. Yeah.
Look at how shiny they are. This looks so CD-i.
This isn't arcade emulation. They sexied up the sprites. They made them look all shaded. Starring Miss Pac-Man. Arcade levels. Battle zones. Team Spirit. Death traps. What? 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 What?
I like this. I like that it has death traps.
All right, let's go. Oh god, I have to play this with the mouse. God help me. Oh, never mind, it's slow as shit. I can do this.
Watch out for death traps.
Hang on a second, I gotta turn this down. Oh, I'm watching out. Oh god, it's so hard to control the mouse.
You're doing alright so far.
I have to pick up the mouse and then like drag it. It sucks.
It's actually really funny watching Danny. They are just dragging the mouse around.
It's like playing with a broken joystick. So this is Miss Pac-Man. At its original resolution, so it uses scrolling, since it was in vertical format. Oh jeez. And I guess it has new mazes called, like, death traps. That does look like a death trap here. This is definitely a death trap.
Oh, that is a death trap. Whew. Nice.
Oh, fuck. Come on. It's Miss Pac-Man. As you knew it. That cherry has three! That's a mutant cherry.
That's
I don't want
disgusting.
That. Get that away from me. That's gross to me. This is heresy. You can't just put an extra bulb on the cherry.
So how does this control with a mouse?
Real bad. Extremely bad.
Are you having fun?
The CD-i did have a variety of controllers it needed to support, so every single game did need to have mouse support in addition to controller support.
I guess that's the Mortal Kombat font that they're using, yes.
Maybe this is why they're all funky looking. They've been eating those three cherries.
It gives you that sheen.
It turns you 16-bit. Fuck, just go in the... I don't want that. Get that away from me. Alright, let's go in the death trap now that no one's looking.
Alright, there you go.
She's also a little bit over-animated. It looks kind of uncanny to me. Oh boy, here we go. Oh, here we go. Don't mind me. I reached the edge of the mouse mat. I was not prepared for that. And I went, hur. That's the new Miss Pac-Man death noise. No. No. No! Go! God help me if I'm gonna play Galaga after this.
Don't.
One to go. Of course you're camping it, you fuck, you absolute shit turd! Fuck you! Fuck you, Blinky.
Are you alright, sweetie?
No. That is the Mortal Kombat font.
Mm-hmm.
See what Battle Zones looks like. Yeah, what if they kept put Mouse Cop in this? This is a fucked up maze! Don't make me eat my way through this maze. There's not even any power pellets. What's wrong with you? Ugh, disgusting. Huh?
What?
Uh-oh.
It's fine. Don't worry about it. It's okay.
Okay. Let's reset. Let's go.
No, it was fine.
Let's play a shoot 'em up.
Okay.
With mouse controls. That would be appropriate, at least. We haven't gotten to a Peter Sellers situation just yet. But maybe we're due. Alright, let's see. How did they sexy up Galaxian, a 1979 game for the CD-i?
I think everything is going to have a little bit of extra shine on it, and it's going to look really ugly. Oh, what did I say?
Or maybe it'll look really cool.
Okay, maybe it'll look good. Maybe I'm wrong. Here we go. Wow, they didn't do shit.
Yeah, they didn't do shit to this.
They were just like, no.
All right, this controls a lot better with the mouse. Ugh. At least they kept in the thing I hate most about Galaxian, the fact that the entire fleet will stop if you miss a shot. Galaga, they realized it's more fun to accidentally hit the aliens with a missed shot. That was the true genius.
Mm.
Of Tommy Galaga, the guy who made it.
Thank you, Tommy Galaga.
Later, he changed his name to Talarico.
Danny.
He invented video games.
I heard he invented music.
Yeah. People never used to listen to music.
Yeah, until he came around.
Music was just this.
Mm-hmm.
It was boo, boo, boo. Oh, that was sick.
Oh, that was good.
Oh, someone answered the phone.
I was gonna say phone call.
Oh. We beat Galaxian.
You won.
We won. I assume there's infinite waves of this.
Mm-hmm.
So you can have infinite pleasure with Galaxian on your CD-i. Only in Europe, though.
It sounds like a cigarette commercial.
Hey, that's new. They added that in.
Okay.
That's something. Hey, Rachel. Welcome. This is completely normal Galaxian. Oh, it doesn't let you freaking exit? You gotta reset the damn CD-i? Alright, let's see what Galaga looks like and then wash our hands of this entire situation. Galaga, probably the most advanced of these three games.
Mm.
Wonder if the CD-i can handle it. Cool. Looking good. Looking like a Galaga.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this ain't good. Okay, well.
Hey, what happened?
Well, in the upper left corner of the screen, you can clearly see Galaga.
I don't think this is emulated correctly.
No, this is multi-screen Galaga.
Okay.
It's the special edition that they released and instantly recalled because no one liked it.
Okay, that was my bad.
I don't think this is gonna work. All right, arcade classics on Philips CD-i. Excellent. Good. The CD-i, not great at arcade games, it must be said. But you know what it is good at? It's good at CD-i quizzes. Let's do the Archeon CD-i quiz, exclusive to the Netherlands.
Okay, let's quiz ourselves.
How much do you know about the CD-i in the Netherlands?
I know a little. Do I know enough?
Yeah, that's like two different levels of emulation. The CD-i couldn't handle it. Quiz time.
Quiz time, you ready to quiz?
CD-i quiz show. That would be cool if I started a quiz show for a CD-i and no one ever got a single correct answer.
I feel bad, but I think there's people who would be on the show who would actually destroy us.
Yeah, maybe. Whoa!
Alright, I like this.
Alright. What's this? Oh. Herbie is the special Archeon Park Gids. You see.
Uh-huh.
Let's start.
Okay.
Yeah. Wheatleg. Tij machine.
Prehistory.
It means tijt. Midluin. Which one of these do you want?
Midluin.
All right.
Which I assume is the Middle Ages.
Dit is Gravedam Vanut. Which one?
It's Het Westen.
That's correct.
Cool.
Good job, Alex.
I guess I know a little bit.
Tij machine goes brr. It's real... real dark and cloudy day here in...
Yeah, this ending is...
No, you get a mastodon butt for that.
I didn't mean to get ass. I don't want ass.
What's this? Shout, Schippen, Burgermeister, rad.
I'm rad. You can't be Burgermeister?
You can't be Burgermeister. You have to earn that. All right, next question.
Okay.
It's a thatch roof cottage.
This has got to be Kuiper.
No, you get a butt.
Gosh.
You rack up 3 butts. Game's over.
I don't want 3 asses.
Which kind of thatch roof cottage is this?
Gosh, get one. Hey!
Nice.
Okay.
Nice work.
I am doing a very good job of guessing.
Yeah, these houses are full of kids playing with their CDIs. what kind of house is this?
This has got to be a Kuiper.
No!
Gotta stop picking that.
No, Alex! That's clearly designed to trick you. This is obviously a Van Eyck hut.
That's... obviously!
Mm-hmm. I've seen plenty in my time.
Well, let's you got do a new spell.
Let's do a newer spell. Start. Let's do prehistory. Wow, this photo was taken in prehistory?
It is. Yeah.
This one?
Yeah.
No. Obviously. This is De Hut.
It is the... Damn, you're really good at this.
Yeah. I study my, my Dutch huts.
You know your huts.
What's Wheatleg? Oh, okay. It's just extra stuff for teachers, I guess. Maybe this is just an educational disc to teach you about, various architectural structures throughout, history. I want to see what the earliest one is.
I was going to say, do you feel educated?
A little bit, but I already know this, you know.
Yeah, what is that
what
thing?
What for dear is dit? God, is that amphibia or reptile? It's probably amphibia, right? No,
amphibia.
It's reptile. It's invis.
It's invis.
Hey, I'm Sparklefish.
Wow, that fish looks nice.
And Beavis. I wanted it to be Beavis. Oh, it was Crack Beanvis. Sorry, I get those mixed up all the time. That's just a blunt at the bottom of the ocean. Well, fish is not my area of expertise. I know about thatch roof cottages. I didn't go to fish school.
You should have gone to fish school.
Someone get in touch with Chris Wiegandt. We got many questions for him.
Mm-hmm.
Huh. There we go.
Pants service, yeah.
Yet another educational disc for the Philips CDI. Well, we've seen nothing but Europe-exclusive discs so far. Why not continue the tradition? This one looks pretty good. This one was advertised. It looks like it has a good degree of budget put into it.
Okay.
What do you say we play Asterix, Caesar's Challenge?
I bet this is going to be a minigame compilation.
You think so?
That or quiz.
Yeah, there's something about languages you can almost understand. Like, I got amphibian and reptile from that. CDI, see how well you can fake knowing a language. All right, Asterix, save this stream. He's going to beat up the beast. He's going to destroy the statues of her hated sisters.
I was going to say, he's going to smash those statues.
A chargeur company. Oh, no. No, yes, no, yes. No! Is in Fulgrom.
The year is 50 BC. Gaul is entirely occupied by the Romans. Well, not entirely. One small village of indomitable Gauls still holds out against the invaders.
Aha, thatch roof cottages.
And life is not
you
easy
remember those.
For the Roman legionnaires who garrison the fortified camps of Tortorum, Aquarium, Laudanum, and Compendium.
He said you must re-enlist. He said to re-enlist.
Save us, Asterix.
Well, welcome, Nis. We are doing Asterix Caesar's Challenge.
Hey, welcome. Hope you're ready to learn.
It's from France.
There's like 10 different versions of this disc, dude. There's like,
Caesar
it's in French
that
and
he
German.
He feels pity for us. That's why he didn't conquer our village. He doesn't think any of us is capable of getting out of this enclosure. I defy the puny Gauls. I'll never permit them to travel through this empire.
Yeah, tell them.
We're going to prove to Caesar that no frontier can hold back the indomitable Gauls.
Yeah, see what a budget gets you? It gets you some nice art.
And no matter where you visit in his empire, bring back the proof that you were there.
Asterix just looks like it was built for CDI. It's a natural fit. That's our pal Obelix.
Yeah,
he's the big
guy.
That's Asterdog. Doggerix. I don't need to learn the rules. I just want to play.
Yes, go. Dogmatix? Is
Which
that really the name?
Who has decided to accept the challenge of Caesar?
Oh, yeah, his name is Dogmatix. That's cool. All right, who are we?
We should be Asterisk.
Is it going to let me pick? Reflection?
Yeah, easy.
Choose your level.
Done.
Fix.
I think there's an icon in the previous screen that we're supposed to see, and I'm not seeing it. So navigating this will be a little difficult, especially considering that the game has crashed. Yeah, it's crashed. Let's restart this.
Okay, let's try again.
Let's see if we can navigate the menu blind and start up a game of Asterix, Caesar's Palace, or whatever this is called.
Caesar's Palace.
Caesar's Challenge, yeah, there you go.
Caesar claims that he feels...
He feels what? What does he feels?
Challenge of Caesar.
All right, let's start.
No, no.
Your marker is yellow to match your whiskers.
Start.
To you, and may the sky never fall on your head.
All right, we did it. We're in. Yeah, looks good.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there's a boob, Asterix.
I didn't see it.
And here we go for 1 hour, 30 minutes of fun.
We're not going to have an hour and 30 minutes of fun with this. That's pretty optimistic, dude.
Yeah, I think this is a board game. Some sort.
Yep, we're rolling the old dice. It's Asterix party. Stop. Oh.
You fell in the hole.
Doink.
Cool.
Yeah.
Alright, go again.
Kika the Faker is lost. Help him find his way back to the palace by using the flying carpets.
Okay.
Watch out for vertigo.
Hey, there's Gaston. Oh my god. Oh no. Don't make me do this.
You can do it.
This is hell.
It's okay, just wait.
Oh man.
And... okay, no, it's okay. There you go.
See, if you just click the button, he just jumps in place. You have to actually...
Do you think that if it turns around, he's going to fall off?
Yeah, probably.
Watch this. Here it goes. Here it goes.
Oh,
yep,
my God.
Yep, this game blows.
Fuck. Luckily, I'm not playing with anyone else, so only I know my suffering.
The Romans are getting above themselves. I'm counting on you to put their camp in order.
All right, kick their ass.
All right.
Good job.
Wait a minute. I didn't know that was the interactive point. I just got my ass kicked for no reason.
Are you ready for Maestria's question?
Are you?
The Sphinx has the body of which animal?
That would be a lion.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Good work! Don't leave without this superb souvenir.
Thank you.
We got the Sphinx.
Party games always feel lethargic on the CD-i.
Yeah, they're very, people had more patience back then. I'm sure that's true.
Yes.
It's your choice.
I think I picked no. Well, whatever. Dogs at the pyramid. Dogs at the pyramid.
Dog at the pyramid.
Dog at the pyramid. Whoa, hey!
Dog died at the pyramid.
I thought it crashed, so I sped up. The dog tricked me. Gotta go Asterix.
Pirate ship dead ahead.
Pie-ass.
By Benelos, you'll have to hit anyone who so much as shows his nose.
Okay.
Hey, we have a game here.
Hey.
It's interactive.
And it's multimedia, so, you know.
Uh-huh. We're getting multiple medias at once. Are these pirates? They look really old.
They're pirates.
What the fuck?
Sorry,
Asterix.
You missed him earlier, and I didn't want to see him. And yeah, no, I'm sorry. It's really bad.
Asterix.
Please make our life easier, Asterix. That fucking sucked.
Asterix.
Once again, Fully Automatics has told Unhygienics his fish aren't fresh. That means those fish are about to fly. You have to help the blacksmith dodge them. You'll need to be as slippery as an eel.
Let's be as slippery as an eel. Ah. Man, they don't do a great job of telling you when it's time to take action.
What do you mean my fish isn't fresh?
My fish isn't fresh. We're speeding on through this.
The voyage continues.
Where was the main centra of tin mining? Was it Northern Ireland, Cornwall, or Wales? Smubblebear, thank you for the 65 months!
Oh shit, thank you!
Fresh, fresh. I think it was in Cornwall.
You'll have to be quicker. Will you try once again the next time you pay a visit?
Yes, ma'am.
You're kicking me out? You don't even give me another chance? All right. Uh-oh.
We don't get it here.
Is this a board game within a board game? Oh, wait, no, this is just the overall board.
We want to leave right away?
Yes. Oh. Where do we find Tim and Bear? I think they'd know how to have fun.
I think they're too busy in the hospital.
Yeah, what? We gotta play Tim and Bear at the hospital.
Here's a flask of magic potion for you.
For me.
For me.
Something tells me that in this picture we're about to discover, there's an object that shouldn't be there.
Oh boy, are you excited?
You find it.
Time to play a hidden object game. What doesn't belong here? Bicycle?
Oh my god.
By Benilos. What an eye you've got, Asterix.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good job.
Yeah, I'm a genius.
You're the ruler of games.
Now's the time to take a chance. Do you want to?
No.
No.
Pity. You might have won a sestercius or two.
I don't give a shit.
I'll just have to live with the what-ifs.
I don't live with FOMO.
Asterix
this
FOMO.
This is Spain. Olé!
Weetabix. Who did Augustus fight in his last campaign? The Lusitanians? The Cantabrians? I'm gonna say this.
Wrong answer. If you use up a dose of magic potion, you can try again. Do you want to do that?
Sure. Let's retry the quiz.
Mm-hmm.
Let me remind you, the Philips CD-i had a single-speed CD-ROM drive, and occasionally it would take a few tries to read the disc. Even though this is MAME, this is accurate. Or the game just crashed. Yeah, the game just crashed. Asterix, Caesar's Challenge. It looks good. It's got some problems. Fix up the crashing bugs and maybe we'll have something here. Peter Sellers!
Sellers!
Hell. Astronomie Flamarion, Étoile les Galaxies.
All right, I guess this is astronomy.
French astronomy, Alex.
Oh, okay, so it's going to be smoking cigarettes.
Alex.
What?
Let's learn about space. The French way.
Sorry, it'll be eating a baguette.
Alex!
Sorry.
There are French people watching this. Eating baguettes as we...
That's not fair. You're right. There are very nice French people who watch and support us. I should be nice.
So there's multiple language versions of mini games, but I think this one is France exclusive.
Regardez. Ouvrez vos yeux à la nuit étoilée. Du spectacle du ciel sur...
Yeah, CD-i had a big presence in France.
Et intelligence. La beauté de la nature est minérale.
It's kind of interesting thinking of it as a Europe-exclusive system, because so many games were just exclusive to European regions, and among those, many were exclusive to certain countries even. Can we take that balloon into the galaxy?
Yes.
You had driving lessons on CD-i, that rules. I wonder if that's preserved.
de la chimie cosmique.
Astrology means breast examination in French. Oh no.
Grandit la réflexion sur le monde physique. Le discours perd sa simplicité première. La communion.
This goes on. Whoa! Look at this. Look at this icon. Look at that, it's space.
What are you doing? Oh, okay.
Which star do you want to blow up today, Alex?
I saw what I thought was a Big Dipper. I don't know.
How about this one?
Yeah, this looks good. Fuck that star. Dragon! Okay, don't blow it up.
Okay, you got it. Another dragon. Let's zoom in. I'm gonna keep zooming in on this one. We're gonna see what this dragon star is all about.
You gotta learn about it. I bet it's the hottest star in the galaxy.
You would think that.
Sorry, I just, you know, would like a few more dragons in our life. Oh, hello.
I think this is maximum zoom.
One second.
Did the cat come out?
Yeah, Tess wants to leave. One second, let me let her out.
Tess is like, space is boring.
She hates dragons, what can I say?
Expert mode. Good soundscape in this, at least. We're going here.
Okay, where's there? Yes?
I think this is too big brain for me.
Yeah, this is really... This is like... I don't know enough about stars to do this.
Atoms.
Now this is about like the stars network, I could do it, but instead.
Invisible à l'œil nu.
Hey, it's Neptune.
La planète Neptune est le seul corps du système solaire dont la présence a été découverte par le seul calcul. À la fin du 19e siècle, les astronomes Adams et Le Verrier ont déduit son existence et sa position de l'observation d'irrégularités dans les orbites d'Uranus.
Where's the fun? You're going to be asking that with a lot of CD-i games.
There's not a lot. There's. I mean, you're learning, isn't that fun?
It looks like there's a lot to this. Space is a big place. Well, that's what atmosphere means. Good presentation. It makes you feel pretty spacey playing this.
Mm-hmm.
This is definitely a CD-i game for sure.
This is one of those games where you're just like, here, kids.
Let's do the hyper telescope.
What? Imagine being like 12 years old and this is the only game you have.
Space is an ocean of space.
It's true.
Savez-vous ce qui me
concerne? It's almost like a space ocean.
Le fait que vos molécules contiennent les éléments chimiques d'anciennes étoiles.
C'est vrai. Cela me console de bien des choses. Mais surtout, ce qui me rend serein, c'est de savoir que les étoiles naines, de moins de 10 masses solaires, évoluent calmement.
Cool. We launched ourselves into the sun.
Constitue un exemple éloquent de cette tranquillité.
I don't think we should do that.
Comme un signe rassurant pour l'avenir.
I think we would burn.
Let's do it.
No.
Next week, the Retro Pals are launched directly into the sun.
Vous avez remarqué,
for our latest adventure.
Pas de nuages et pas de lune. C'est vraiment
assez. We're taking all the CD-i games with us.
Moi qui allais vous parler de joyaux célestes.
Honestly,
de cavernes d'Ali Baba.
Vous êtes charmant. Mais la réalité ne manque pas de merveilleux. Regardez, 3000 étoiles au moins sont visibles à l'œil nu.
Billions and billions.
Elles appartiennent à notre galaxie, comme le Soleil.
Of the stars.
Elles brillent grâce.
Sorry, I'm not good at French.
You're good enough.
Well, we could spend the next 20,000 years drifting through space on CDI.
Auquel le Soleil appartient. Notre galaxie avec un G majuscule, s'il vous plaît. Qui, telle notre voisine Andromède, que vous voyez là, parcourt les espaces comme un grand vaisseau cosmique.
Du calme.
Yeah, when you say it all in French, it does sound more dramatic, more epic.
Nous avons de celle-ci une vision incomplète et
déformée.
Well, if you want to know about space, if you want to be launched into the sun, the Philips CD-i is the place
pour
to do it.
Que je sache, la du-
How well. About, instead of that, we learn about audiovisual projects, 1992 and 1993 on CD-i. Now this is my realm of expertise. I don't know about no space. I don't know about no breast examination. I do know about the software on the Philips CD-i, though.
Are we skipping the breast examination?
Do you want to play the breast examination? Do you want to take the risk? Do you want to roll the dice on that one?
No. But I'm also a completionist, so.
Yeah! Yeah!
All right, here we fucking go.
Audio video products, 92-93.
Mammogram Monday, thank you.
Another French disc, apparently.
Choose your country.
Oh, this is suited for many countries. Let's stick with, let's go to Italy. What's CD-i look like in Italy? Ooh. That's what I'm saying.
I'm always saying no testo. Yeah, that's choosing language is choosing your country. Oh my god.
Benvenuto nel menu principale di questo CD-i. Esso contiene numerose informazioni sui nuovi prodotti Philips, classificati in categorie.
I want the Philips Handycam. I want to put that on the CD-i. Can I burn discs full of the video that I record?
Se desideri consultare informazioni sui prodotti Matchline, ad esempio.
Oh, it wants you to buy all in. It doesn't want you to mix and match the brands. Mm-mm. It's got to be all Philips.
I like the big audiovisual receiver, like tower.
Yeah.
I want that.
It's got so many knobs.
Questo menu ti permette anche di cambiare lingua. Per informazioni relative.
English. Service my CD-i. In Italy.
In Italy.
All right. Well, this is a disc to tell you where you can get your CD-i serviced.
Camcorders. CD-i satellite reception. Color TV. Portable audio. Video recorders.
Video recorders.
Video recorder. Hi-fi. Matchline.
Hi-fi.
Oh my god, it's majestic.
High fidelity. The essence of Philips audio components and systems.
Yes, there's smaller knobs. Oh, there's so many knobs.
As you might expect, they've the features and programming facilities that help make life that little bit easier. The shape and form.
Me!
That comes from
That's me.
Imaginative yet practical design. And
the sophisticated European listening to my hi-fi
I love this.
In my sophisticated European chair.
But it's their sound quality that makes them special.
You stick a tuning fork in your ear? Don't do that.
I mean, what if you're...
Whoa, weird! Weird! Whoa! I've never seen a cassette player that loads like that. Like a pop-out drive.
Yeah.
Philips also gives you the very best in analog sound from the powerful MIDI system.
Kids today would look at that and think, oh, that's normal. I've never used a cassette.
And last, but by no means least, the
like, that's what just that's just what cassettes
system.
Do.
Philips Audio. Sound reproduction as faithful to the original as you can get.
You think they cracked open an actual Corinthian column to put some CD-i shit on top of it?
Yes. They're just like, the Greeks don't need this shit.
Oh, it's their own digital cassette format. That's why it loads strangely. They got the proprietary cassette format.
Okay.
Mini hi-fi systems. MIDI hi-fi systems. MIDI hi-fi systems.
Which one of these do you want?
MIDI hi-fi systems.
All right.
Make my MIDI pop.
In this menu, you can select the following. The return button will take you back to the product category menu.
I know how to return.
90s hi-fi for 90s people. Incorporating the latest technology, such as DCC, the new world standard for digital recording, And of course, a Bitstream CD player is also included.
Oh, they mean MIDI as in medium, not the all caps MIDI.
Boo, boo, boo.
You did a French boo for a second.
I did. Went, boo. I've been French. I'm Frenchified.
We're French fried. Let's go back to the main menu. This is pretty interesting. I kind of like this disc.
CD-i.
Overview? Oh, we're going into CD-i heaven. Go towards
the
light.
That's me.
We want to show you a range of products that Philips is most proud of.
Oh, please.
First stop, high-quality TVs in all shapes and sizes.
I like the TVs.
Oh, products we got jams.
Distinctive design and superb picture and sound quality. Products for families at home and for individuals on the move.
This is very vaporwave, yes.
There's a lady in leather back there. CD-i for her.
And the means to capture those magic moments, as large or as small as you want them. Here is an exciting new Philips technology. An interactive compact disc
of all the games
that brings you a new world.
I want a Rolodex TV.
Entertainment on your TV.
Oh,
I want that.
Then straight on to a stunning collection. The Philips collection.
Oh, I don't even know what that is.
Oh, I want that.
Design and quality. Portable power too. In sound machines
Sick.
With digital technology.
I want that jam box.
And mm-hmm. clocks that do much more than simply tell the time.
What do they do?
Compact mini systems.
What do they do?
What?
Oh, this is classic Beethoven.
Innovations like DCC, the digital successor of the compact cassette.
I had never heard of DCC before. That is wacky to me.
I want to learn more about it.
And finally, real hi-fi. The world's first system.
Can I get fake
hi-fi? Components. The 900.
You want to get a Sorny?
Or yes, I want a Kobe.
Or a magnet box. All right, I'm ready to ascend to CD-i heaven. And the rest of you want to come with me?
I guess. I mean, I guess I could go to worse places when I die.
Benno de Groot. Good work. Peter Van Dyck, nice work.
Mm-hmm. Nice dick.
Alex! No Roof Productions, get yourself a roof!
They don't need one because they tore the roof off because it was so sick.
They blew the roof off the joint.
Yeah, good sax.
Man, I'm all in. Mm-hmm. I'm energized to check out the CD-i now. So vaporwave. So ahead of its time.
Yeah, get all vaporwave freaks in here. Look at this shit.
Wow. Amazing.
Good shit.
The next disc is called Axis and Allies. However, it has a bunch of Nazi shit in it, which I don't really want on this stream, so we're going to skip it.
Cool.
Let's do a repeat performance of a classic that we played before on console. I want to see this again on MAME now that we can see it in full resolution. Let's play Backgammon. Y'all remember this one?
I'm pretty sure Axis and Allies was the board game about World War II, but...
Mm-hmm. It's got a bunch of swastikas flags on it, though. I don't want to see that. I want to see Backgammon.
Yeah.
And it does play out like a board game, where you're going across Europe and stuff.
Alright, Able Instant Messenger is back.
I miss AIM.
I know. We used to talk on it.
We did. And I had to use it for my job at AOL.
That is so funny that you still had to use it.
They made you use AIM. You couldn't use Discord.
Or Slack, I assume.
No, we had something called Campfire, which is like bootleg Slack.
I remember Campfire. Does Campfire still exist?
Now, the great thing about this game is it has a Philips CD-i quality animation for your opponents. Let's check it out. I'll be this one. Oh, yeah, you get to put together a playlist of classical music. Let's put in some Haydn and some Bach.
Wow, he looks great.
Yeah.
Lord Wadsworth Higginbottom, having returned from the India campaigns where he held the rank of colonel in the 4th Royal Procurement Regiment, spends most of his time at the Adventurers Club. When not seated in his favorite overstuffed chair reading the Times, he engages in his beloved pastime, backgammon. Since his days at Eton, where he was last in his class, Lord Higginbottom has been known as an easy mark at backgammon. The combination of bad luck and lack of clear strategy has robbed him of the decisive victory he so desires. It is known around the club that his bulldog, the ever-faithful Wellington, mascot of the 4th Regiment, is a more adept player. As a rather slow and bumbling gentleman of a bygone era, he is ever seeking new competition. Unfortunately, everyone at the club is quite bored with his game. Would you mind engaging Lord Higginbottom in a friendly game?
Hey, this guy sucks ass. You want to play him?
This guy fucking sucks.
Not even the people at his bullshit club like him. Now, some adaptations of board games for CD-i are really straightforward and boring. This is not one of them. We roll the dice. There we go. The people in this game have really long arms. Can we click the dog? I like the dog giving us the bedroom eyes. Oh, I had to roll.
Yeah.
All right, so.
Do you play backgammon much?
I used to play it with you in Clubhouse games, but I forgot how to play it.
Yeah. I barely remember. That and just moved across 7 or whatever. Yeah.
I forgot how to play backgammon. Or the game's not letting me.
I was gonna say, I don't think the game's letting. Oh, there you go. You did some.
I'm just gonna click around until it lets me do my thing. The guy's like, finally, a guy I can beat. He doesn't even know what backgammon is. The dog follows your pointer, and so does the guy.
I like that. Okay.
Indeed, Wellington. This is most indecent.
Dog just peed. Hey. Sorry.
Most indecent.
Indeed, Wellington. This is most indecent.
Shouldn't have gone to India, bro. Shouldn't have done colonialism.
Yeah. We cut you a little slack. Now let's see the other people. The other people are good, too.
All right.
Let's do average guy. And I'll be light this time. So this one, I want some Rick Astley. There we go.
The Count, rumored to be a descendant of the Tsar, is a notorious playboy and gambler.
H.
His manners are impeccable. His style
golden.
Chic and suave. He is seen at the most lavish gambling casinos.
Casino H.
By beautiful women. One, in particular, is always in his company at the backgammon tables. Ms. Penelope Puffin, most recently of Kansas City, is often seen whispering in the Count's ear.
Penelope Puffin!
Penelope!
How he maintains this opulent lifestyle abound. His charm and wit are no secret, especially among ladies of means. It is said that his father...
This is how Alex wakes up every morning.
I guess I do. I have a... Years earlier. A giant cigar. Player,
he is and a Bloody Mary.
Seeking his next victim. Are you willing to take the risk?
A little bit higher stakes with the count.
Smebel, he wasn't assassinated with the rest of the royal family because he had a lot of cigars. And the Bolsheviks saw a baby smoking a cigar and they're like, well, we can't kill this guy. Well, shit.
Hint me, Penelope.
My dear, what are you doing?
He's fine with it. Do you like click and drag? Or I don't think the CD-i is advanced enough for click and drag.
Yeah, I don't know how you do this.
I think I played this last time, but...
Okay.
The long arms.
I love the long arms.
All right, let's check out the most advanced opponent. I bet you there's animations for beating these people, but man, that would take a long time. I'm going to have to do that off stream.
Mm-hmm.
And for expert, we get her.
Who is she?
For her, we want Beethoven.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
The queen. Reigns over a great palace of Rad amid scores of fantastic creatures from all corners of the galaxy. She commands an army of robots, androids, and machines which aid her in maintaining an iron rule over the planet Rad. She disdains the company of humanoids, particularly men. Her only passions are the latest technology and backgammon. With her Oort, the all-seeing eye, floating nearby at the backgammon module, she challenges all comers. It is known throughout the galaxy that she is a brilliant and cunning foe. You are welcome at the palace, provided that you amuse the queen sufficiently. In the past, few have been successful against her. Those who have failed never left Rad. If you enter the great palace, will you be ready for the challenge?
Gaslight, gatekeep, backgammon boss.
I guess she's the ultimate girl boss.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we just take a turn into sci-fi with this one. Notice that she's big on technology, they said, so of course she has a CD-i in it.
CD-i, of course.
I like this clock. We get a digital dice roll. Let's talk to her friend.
Do you really think that will help?
I like her. I hope she kills us.
She hates men.
Fair enough.
She just wants to be on her sci-fi planet where she plays backgammon all day, preferably against women.
And listen to the CD-i with her long, long
arms. Her extremely long arms. This is backgammon. For some reason, they put more effort into this one than many of the other board game adaptations we've seen on CD-i.
Do you really think that will help?
I do.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see that long arm one more time.
She's thinking.
She's thinking on it. Ah, she has an idea.
She's thinking about extending her arms.
Just like all the way across the screen.
Yeah, she doesn't have the Greek pillars of the other CD-i people. I don't know what her problem is.
I'm leaving. I will enjoy my stay on planet Rad without backgammon, thank you. Well, that's emulated perfectly. If you want to play backgammon on CD-i, you can play it in MAME. Andy House? Isn't Andrew House like a guy?
I think he is.
Like a PlayStation guy?
Yeah, Chad, do you know who Andrew House is? Other than the inventor of house music?
Don't duplicate this disc.
Don't do it.
Don't do it. It's not worth it. absolutely not worth it. Shax, that's good. There should have been a CD-i adaptation of Chess the Musical. So speaking of which, let's do one of the lamer board game adaptations. He was the president of Sony, wasn't he? I wonder if it's the same guy. Also, hey, Big Bang.
Welcome.
Now, Battleship is more straightforward, more straight-laced. It's more for the Battleship fans. If you're a Battleship fan, you may like this game.
Battleship fans, chime in. All five of you. Are there Battleship Capital Disc Interactive?
Mm-hmm. 50,000 fine is more than global sales. Yeah, probably. Let's compete versus computer. Dong. Five shots at a time. Fuck it. We're playing lightning round Battleship.
I was gonna say, this is really fast.
Deploy. That all looks good. Oh, I see. It's rearranging for me. But I can also... I can also do this on my own. I'm ready.
Honey,
can
you put the screen on?
God damn it. Fucking shit. Here's Battleship for the CD-i. It looks a little more, normal than, Backgammon. Here, let me show you.
Yeah, let's look.
See, Capital Disc Interactive?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. The name Battleship is copyright.
That's kind of messed up that Battleship is copyright.
Yeah.
It's just a thing. Hey, anchors away, my friend. Anchors away.
Anchors away, my friend. Let's get Captain Salty out here. Fog of War is crazy. I just get immersed sometimes, you know?
Your cousin owned this game?
That's and beautiful. Mystic Midway? Oh. Oh my god. Of all the games. Yeah, look at this presentation compared to the Backgammon. Get in and play and get out. Five shots at a time, because we're playing lightning round Battleship. Move this one over here, and I think we're ready.
I like the real war footage.
Yeah, and the tiny, tiny window. Is that ship number 69?
Nice. It does look like a Windows 3.1 game, yeah.
Here. Spoosh. Here. Another sploosh. Here. Kaboom! We hit something.
Ooh.
Another miss. Is it over here?
Yes! Uh-huh. Yes, you're gonna kill them, honey.
We're getting them. That's my five shots, though. Let's see the computer. Let's see what they can do. No, my dinghy! Alright, you're way off. We're gonna play this until we sink one ship.
Okay, we will sink a ship.
Not one of mine, though.
Mm-mm.
Is that the strategy to... Oh, man, you did it! You sunk my thing!
Sorry, honey. There goes your, medium ship.
My medium ship. I'm gonna sink this guy's medium ship.
Mm-hmm.
Check it out, see?
Get his ass.
Kablam! Suck it.
Yeah, it's the MIDI ship.
The MIDI ship. Oh, fancy.
Oh. You sunk it.
I sunk your shit. What are you gonna do about it? This is okay. It's not backgammon.
No, backgammon's better. I like the animation more.
But at least it has little tiny videos.
You know, I've never seen the Battleship movie. Danny, have you?
I have not.
That is some shit that should be on Tubi.
I agree. Oh, they're loading them up. Some of this footage is pretty interesting. I guess that's the essence of multimedia. See, way back then, you couldn't just load up YouTube and see, like, Battleship footage. You had to go to CD-i. There should have been commercials for kids back then of VHS tapes of great Battleship battles.
Yes! Like there were for, like, grandparents or whatever.
Mm-hmm. In between the ads for, the
Jaffa blocks?
Yeah, Jaffa blocks.
Floating in midair. I'm sorry they're sinking all your shit.
Computer is psychic. Also, it knows where all the things are anyway, and it has to pretend like it doesn't.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's a problem. I don't like this. No, I'm not going to put up the interstitial anymore because I just keep forgetting about it. Alex?
Fuck it. You're in charge of Rolo, though.
All right. Heading into uncharted territory. Anyone know what a breast looks like?
Never heard of it before.
I'm going to play chicken with this game. I think I'm going to play like 15 seconds of this. I don't know if we could get very far in this. It is emulated in MAME. You can figure out how to examine the breasts at home. This is ominous.
English, please.
The pointer you see on the TV screen allows you to activate specific areas of this program. Practice moving the pointer with your controller. When the pointer is moved over an active area,
I agree! There should be a medical interest exception to nudity on Twitch.
Yeah, this is legit educational.
You will see the pointer turn red and the button.
You walked into education.
This area is now available, and by pressing the action button on your controller, you will activate this topic. Press your controller to start the program.
So it's literally just how to use a mouse.
Yeah.
Breast cancer is the most common form.
They're judging
of
me.
Among
oh, I can't
women.
Do this.
She's looking at
they're
you.
All...
out of every 9 American women will develop breast cancer.
I'm being judged hardcore by these women.
182,000 women.
Also, this is a very serious
over
medical program and
it
I don't
is.
Expect to get much laugh many laughs out of it.
Cancer.
This is
a cancer death.
Yeah, if you wanna figure out how to breast examine on your own,
could be much
this is in MAME. I ain't gonna touch this.
Thank you. We did pretty good.
Brian Adams waking up the neighbors.
I think our stream already wakes them up.
46,000 women. Is that what it said?
Mm-hmm.
Freaking CD-i. Try to teach me about a thing. I'll show you. Now we're learning about Brian Adams.
Yeah, it's truly the summer of 69.
How to examine Brian Adams at home. Oh, we don't have a digital video cartridge. Oh, this is just in the same format as that Peter Gabriel US disc that I have.
Yeah, yeah.
So CD-i had a lot of these discs that were just like compilations of music videos.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, we can't see this because it's requires a thing that's not emulated. Do I have to say the words? The words are, your disc requires the CD-i player to have the digital video cartridge. Catchy song, Brian. Can we see the credits at least? No, we cannot see the credits because even that requires the digital video cartridge. Damn. Well, hell. I guess we'll have to go to Caesar's World of Gambling.
What do you think we're going to gamble?
Life? Everything.
Okay.
You put your life in your hands when you stream breast self-examination for CD-i.
We survived, though. I don't know what the problem is.
I'm never going to forget those women just staring through my soul.
Just like, okay, Danny, you want to mock us? You want to make a joke out of this?
Hey, this is a disc about breast cancer. You think you're hot shit? We ain't going to give you shit to work with. Oh, the CD-i had peripherals, all right.
Mm-hmm.
It had many different controllers, microphones. Tepid Snake, thank you for the 50 whole, the
oh,
60
shit,
whole
thank
months.
Thank you, 60 months.
And a RetroPal sus to you, too. Let's enter Caesar's world.
I want to go to Caesar's palace. I want to gamble.
I'm Caesar. Welcome to Gamble.
Welcome to Caesar's World of Gambling, the first gambling casino on a compact disc.
Ooh.
Please make a selection by clicking on the box of your choice.
I want this box. Let's tour of Caesar's.
Yeah, let's look at Caesar's.
Let's go. If you want to end this tour for some reason, you can end it. Jeez.
Welcome to Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas, a royal wonderland that combines regal hospitality with the finest in modern-day amenities and services.
Hotel what's your restaurant's like?
Ooh! Ooh, look at this.
In Las Vegas. Spacious sleeping and sitting areas adjoin luxurious baths.
Is this where WrestleMania 9 happened?
Yes, it is, actually.
Good.
Giant whirlpool tubs,
this may have been where Doink the Clown slept.
Caesar's Palace offers a world of fine dining.
Whoa, they make the ladies dress up like that?
Not anymore.
What? Why?
Because they have a pretty good union in Las Vegas.
No. Well, that's a good reason.
Caesar's cuisine is prepared in regal style and served with matchless elegance.
There's a lot of vertical food. Vertically oriented food.
And I love this buffet. Oh my god.
Dude, there's so much neon.
It doesn't look like this anymore.
The stars come out, the brightest in the entertainment world. Diana Ross, Julio Iglesias, David Copperfield, and Margaret, Jay Leno.
Yes! Let's go see Jay Leno.
Hey, Danny, I want to go to Caesar's.
Jay Leno has a tiny face.
Visitors rock with the hottest sounds on a floating cocktail lounge. Cleopatra's Royal Barge. Caesar's Palace is always looking for...
I'll take the barge, please.
They still have the barge there, I think.
The Omnimax movie theater is a favorite family attraction. A thrill ride into the future with a dome-shaped movie screen and 9-track stereo sound system that rockets its audience into outer space, under the sea, or through time itself.
Fuck yeah, rocket me through space.
Time itself.
Sophisticated and elaborate sports betting facility.
Wow.
The Olympiad race and sports.
I want to sit there all day.
Are you gonna bet?
No.
Okay.
Room comfort. Caesar's Palace has earned its reputation as home of champions with an exciting calendar of sports events. Throughout its history, internationally famous...
Boxers will kick your ass out if you misbehave. They'll put you in the ring.
When it comes to riches, Caesar's offers an exciting variety of slot machines with jackpots that top $1 million.
They just give you big mounds of money?
Hey, here's a big mound of money. Don't get robbed. Bye.
Let's go.
Table games include blackjack.
Does anybody want to give us a big mound of money?
And exciting oriental games with betting limits to accommodate the novice and high stakes player alike.
What are exciting oriental games?
Guests age 21 or older. And after a long night of entertainment and excitement, what could be more relaxing than a luxurious health spa and salon experience?
Can we show this? That's technically a butt.
I mean, she's covered.
Temper and refresh. The lavish garden of the god swimming pools and
they allow body painting on Twitch, so should be fine.
With two large swimming pools
you play Oriental Hero for ZX Spectrum.
By fountains, statuary, and gardens. Tennis enthusiasts will find a fully staffed outdoor.
I don't think they still have the tennis facility, by the way. I think they actually. That's what I think they turned into Hell's Kitchen. They have a Hell's Kitchen at Caesar's now. Corridor offers treasures from the famous. I kind of want to go.
They got a real size fake David.
Yeah.
Exclusively, stores feature quality leisure
store looks like shit. Sorry.
Along with Caesar's exclusive line of fragrances.
Okay, I want that.
There is something for everyone at Caesar's Palace.
Can we go to Caesar's Palace?
Fuck yeah, let's go.
They have the mall that has the animatronic show. We need to go.
To relive the grandeur that was ancient Rome. The grandeur that is Caesar's Palace.
I'm ready for grandeur.
Mm-hmm. Caesar's Palace is very vaporwave, yes.
I've had enough with the day-to-day grind of being a Twitch retro streamer.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go to Caesar's Palace. Select our symbol.
Rainbow.
You want the rainbow?
Yes.
Finished. Let's go to the casino.
Here we go. Here we fucking go.
Oh, I'm excited.
You got blackjack. Roulette.
Do you think this couple was paid for their inclusion, or did they just take the photo and leave?
Honestly, they look so staged, I want to say that they were, you know, paid to be there, but who knows?
What's Macaulay Culkin doing here?
He's playing craps!
Oh, alright. Well, you know me, my game's blackjack.
Alright. There you go. Hey, ma'am.
I wish to bet one $500 chip on blackjack, please.
Please place your bets.
This one. All right, I hope we win this one, because otherwise we're getting our asses
kicked
out.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we need to go.
The cards have been shuffled.
Oh, fancy. Oh, the cards look like shit.
Wow.
What? You couldn't even see the suits before they zoomed in, and the cards are still, like, generic.
What are you going to do?
This is 19. However, the ace could,
be, yeah.
Straw. Jack and eight. I got the same fucking number. All right, fine. We're standing on 19.
14. Dealer breaks.
Whew.
You won!
Thank God.
You won $1,000!
Let it ride.
Okay.
Go big or go home. I think we're about to go home. Oh, 13. Not a great number to get.
I would draw.
Break.
Well, we're poor.
Please place your bets.
I don't have any money. I'm... Yeah. Let's place more bets and get in debt with the mob. Oh, 15. Yeah, I'm getting my legs broke tonight.
Sorry, honey.
Dealer stands with 18.
Did we tie?
Please place your bets.
Place it again.
All right, here we go. Don't go break bankrupt. Don't, yeah, Danny's going to be gabagool if this keeps up.
18, I guess you want to stand on that. Fuck it, we're drawing.
Break.
Danny. I had a good feeling.
Danny, please, we don't have money. Bets.
It's okay. I got unlimited markers to cover my bets.
Don't do that.
They just give you free money. Probably want to... Let's double down.
Okay.
Yeah. With a marker.
7.
I like the way this is going.
17. Please place your bets.
The cat just opened the door. She knew you were gambling.
She made a noise, too.
Hi. Hi, girly.
We want a lot of money. Now we have $2,000 in marker money to put on this hand.
She just ran out. Again.
Jerk cat.
I know. She's a sweetheart.
16. What would you do?
Hit me.
Oh.
Stand.
16. Dealer stands with 18.
Alex, we're crawling our way back.
Please
up.
Place your
honey,
bets.
You have $4,000.
You know what we gotta do? We gotta head to roulette. What's your favorite number, Alex?
20. I like all the cats because of Tess. Thank you.
Thank you for the cats. Nowadays, she busts down the door so often, I don't even...
Place your bets.
I don't even blink an eye.
Same.
20, eh?
Yeah, 20 just... It feels good.
Your bet exceeds the limit of $200 for this box.
$200.
Let's put the rest of the money on a bunch of other shit.
Okay.
Yeah, just put it all over the place.
Yeah, let's do
your
this.
Your bet exceeds the limit of $200 for this box.
Oh, whatever.
Don't forget you can bet on red and black. Bet on both red and black. Okay, you're really expecting it to go on black, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Danny!
Let's spin that wheel.
We're fucked.
The winning number is 7, red.
No, you don't get it. This is how I win.
Yeah, you're doing uncut gemming it. Danny, I just you gotta, Howie it.
I gotta put this one last bet. Everyone's gonna love me for it. Well, if you want to experience losing your shirt at Caesar's Palace, you can do it on CD-i.
Ooh.
One game of craps. Let's make this complete.
Do you even know how to play craps?
Nope.
Okay.
I'm gonna put it all on cum.
Coming out.
Danny! Oh, okay.
Come and don't come bets cannot be made on the come out roll.
Let's come out roll.
5. The point is 5.
Roll them again.
Yeah, that's good.
8. Hard 8 is off.
What?
Hard 8.
7 out.
7. Lucky 7. Everybody wins.
Place your bets.
See? I told you I was good at craps.
I should have known. Yeah, craps is one of those try not to come games. Alex. I had to say it. I had to say it.
Did you really?
Yes.
Did you really when we were about to play Cartoon Jukebox? There's another one we've played before, but I want to see how it works in MAME. Plus, this could make a good show closer. We're going to make a tune. 7. Lucky 7. Sega CD Euro platformer. Yeah, just hack Time Cop. Turn into Uncut Gems. Remember when we played this and this video screen started rolling like it was on a bad TV?
Like that. That needs to happen again.
It's weird how you get analog and digital glitches from CD-i games, and they're different.
I'm a little jukebox, short and stout. Press my buttons and the music comes out. Change all the colors one by one. Play my games, it's a whole lot of fun. Hi, I'm your cartoon jukebox. We're gonna have fun together. You can listen to my songs, watch cartoon movies, play games with me, and color. Just move your star to whatever you want to do and press an action button.
I want movie, play all. Now, this is a game where you can customize these music videos.
Oh, this was from that one game, remember?
Yeah. Oh yeah, we played this. Wow, it all comes back around.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we colored in this animation, like for a... Excuse me.
Whoa.
I didn't know they were gay. I mean, that just makes it better, of course. I think it tried to crash when we tried to compose a song, but...
Come to think of it, I think that was children's musical theater I'm thinking of.
Maybe.
Cartoon Jukebox is different.
But we've definitely done this before.
Yeah. He got him. Stupid monkey, stupid weasel. You think you can get away with this shit? We're gonna color this bus.
Uh-huh, he's an alien, I like that. It's Europe.
A nice flesh-colored bus.
Oh, I like that. The flesh bus. What? ZZ Top?
Mm-hmm.
In old Dick Tracy. Mm-hmm. Looks good. He's a Smurf. Mm-hmm. I like this guy. I like
this
the piss color.
This guy can be pink.
Mm-hmm.
This ascot can be red. Looking like a character from Cool World.
He is.
We have orange babies.
Mm-hmm. That baby's red with anger. That baby's also red with anger. And a Smurf mom.
Yeah, this is gonna look great. The wheels on the bus go round and yeah, yeah, let's watch this movie. Round and round, the wheels on the bus go round and round, all around in town. How do you watch the movie?
Oh, there you go.
Ah, here we go. Okay.
I don't like its face.
This is gonna be normal. The wheels on the bus go round and round,
round and round, round and round. Why is this so animated?
It does seem pretty animated for CD-i.
I like that you can color how awful it looks.
Yeah. Yeah, it's reflected in the movie. That's pretty
great. I like
that
a lot.
Move on back.
The people on the bus go up and down, up and down, up and down. The people on the bus go up and down, all around the town. The babies on the bus say, wah, wah, wah.
These demon babies.
These awful babies. The babies on the bus say, wah, wah, wah. All around the town.
The parents on the bus say, shh, shh, shh. No one's happy. Not on this bus.
You know, I ride the bus a lot, and it's actually pretty rare that you get a screaming baby. It doesn't happen as much as you'd think. I'm just saying, wheels on the bus is a little inaccurate for modern times.
Yeah, wheels on the bus kind of mid compared to modern music.
It is! Yes, this is Club Drive.
Mary, your little lamb. Alright, what does Mary look like? Mary should be a purple creature. With a pink shirt, blue hair,
mm-hmm.
and a nice highlight.
Beautiful.
The sheep
wow!
is...
Wow!
A nice aqua sheep.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Can't color the eyes.
Bull. Whew. Yeah, this is normal. It's what guys look like. Thank you, Lee Pete for life, for the 4-month resub. Color a stone sheep, exactly.
Thank you. Stop signs are green in this world. I'm the fucking Joker.
Mm-hmm. Perfect.
What color is the school bus?
Blue? Yeah, okay. That's good. That's how buses look.
Alright, here we go. Mary had a little lamb. Oh, she's awful! Mary, look out! Mary, look out!
Mary!
She's got earbuds in. She can't hear us. Good Lord!
No, it's green. Green is puke. Yeah, this is very duck colors. That Mary went, the lamb was sure to go.
It followed her to school one day, school one day, school one day. It followed. It's a good thing I'm very easily amused. That was against the rules. It made the children laugh and play, laugh and play, laugh and play. It made the children laugh and play to see a lamb at school.
Why does the Lamb love Mary so? Mary so, Mary so. Why does the Lamb love Mary so? The eager children cry.
Yeah, why?
I never pictured the Lamb being the size of Godzilla.
Lamb, you know, Mary loves the Lamb, you know, the teacher did reply.
Oh, okay. All right, well, now we know.
Want the day off of school? Just have your giant lamb friend carry you away. This is Cartoon Jukebox for Philips CD-i, an excellent video game. Okay, one more.
Okay.
We got to do Home on the Range.
We do.
All right, we got to have a real Texas colored horse. I like the idea of having green people for these. It works pretty well.
It really does. It's very fashionable.
We have to use all the colors in our palette. Every last one of them. Whoops.
Yeah, that's good. Okay.
There we
go. Very cowboy-esque. Oh my god! Finally, an armadillo! How long has it been?
What color is the armadillo, Alex?
The armadillo is green.
You got it.
Oh, thank you.
How about the bunny?
Purple. Yeah, that's good.
It looks like a Louie from Bomberman now.
It does! I like that.
Whoa!
Why is that ass so...
You know what? You get a green ass.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is nightmares. Nightmares!
No way, this is great.
Looking like Solomon Grundy.
Born on a Multimedia Monday.
I think they could use some sound or music in this part.
Yeah.
Other than that,
dire.
This disc is perfect. No, this lizard should be this color. And the bird should be this color.
And then the blue. Yeah. Cool. Let's go. Right. Let's fucking go.
Here we go. The finale for CD-i Monday. The week of January 9th, 2023. Home on the Range. Oh, man.
This is just how people look, Danny.
Alien cowboy. On the surface of Mars, animals look real bad. This is where all the cowboys have gone.
Home on the range. Won't rest until I see my armadillo. There he is!
There he is!
Alright, we're good! Oh, that's a good animated armadillo.
Lovely. I love you, Cartoon Jukebox. I love you, Philips CD-i. Yeah, this is Red Dead Redemption 3. They're taking a new direction for this. That is the latest episode of Philips CD-i Archaeology with the Retro Pals, covering the old favorites, new stuff, a lot of educational discs in French, a lot of promotional discs in Danish. It's a true worldwide affair when you deal with the Philips CD-i, and I hope you all feel more educated today.
I do too.
We'll be back on Wednesday at 7 p.m. Central. We're doing a video watch-along stream featuring the thing that our patrons voted to see, which is episodes of the old British television show Bad Influence.
Oh, hell yes.
This
hell
is an
yes.
amazing show. Alex and I have watched this all the way through many years ago. Mm-hmm. This is going to be the stream debut of Violet Berlin. It's going to be, it's going to have a lot of stuff from the 90s. Bleeding edge tech, like you might see from the Philips CD-i, but from a British perspective. I'm looking forward to that. So, Alex, why don't you wrap us up?
We are on Patreon, patreon.com/retropals. Vote, pitch in $5 a month. You can vote on when we play every Wednesday. You can even choose bad influence for us. So yeah, do definitely check us out if you'd like to support us directly there. We are also on YouTube, youtube.com/retropals. We post full-length highlights of our streams there, including our latest one, which is a look at Flash games based on movies, including Charlotte's Web, E.T., and The Tale of Despero. So I definitely recommend that one. It's really good. It's really fun. And yeah, queer icon Violet Berlin is finally going to be on our show, so do check us out on Wednesday.
Yeah, it's about time.
Be sure to follow, yeah. Follow and sub if you like, so you can follow us along.
Who the heck is streaming?
Who is streaming? Who on this earth is streaming right now?
Oh my god, is that Wife City?
Holy shit.
I haven't seen them in an age.
Wife City.
Wife City is off of break. They're back, and they're playing Wheel of Fortune. This is going to be a good time. I love the wives. Why don't you give the wives a nice warm welcome back?
Yes,
from the Retro Pals. Straight from Philip CDI to the game show realm. This is a nice, this will be a nice afternoon of streams, I think.
Mm-hmm.
All right, y'all. Enjoy that. Have a good rest of your day. We'll see you later. Thanks for watching.
See ya, folks.